Good afternoon and welcome to the clinic. I am your doctor and I am going to be performing some basic but important tests to see what state you're in. So first I'm going to sanitize the hands. We have a new bottle of antibacterial gel. A nice scent to it as well. Okay, so after I've performed each test, I'll be taking a little pause just to record the results on my pad. So let's start with your heartbeat. Just listening to your cardiac rhythms. So the stethoscope, I just want you to breathe normally for me, please. Just inhale and exhale normally. Okay, take a deep breath, hold it, and breathe out. And again, breathe in, hold it, and out. Just breathe normally now, please. Excellent. So a normal rhythm there. I'm just going to be tapping on your chest, upper chest, very gently now. Just continue breathing normally. First test. So it's using the stethoscope. So we're going to, I'm going to dive into my doctor's bag. And have a look at what tests we can perform now. Okay. So I have this little mouth mirror, just for checking the tongue, teeth, back of the throat and under the tongue. Place this in the mouth, just open wide for me. Good. Just looking into the mirror, just say ah, and again say ah. Good. Okay, just raise the tongue to the roof of the mouth now, please. Just bite your teeth now, grit your teeth, open your mouth again. Good. Look at the back, the tonsil area. And I'll just introduce introduce some light as well. Say R again. Just looking for any inflammation there. Any redness. Excellent. Okay. So that was the oral, mouth, throat examination, which looked all clear. Okay, so I'm going to focus on your ears now. I have the miniature otoscope, so I'm just going to come around the side and look at the right ear first. Just place the otoscope gently inside the ear canal. Excellent. It's clear. There's no discharge or inflammation or scarring. Okay. Just relax, breathe normally. Let's look at the left ear. This looks clear. There's no discharge or redness, inflammation, scarring. Okay, excellent. So next I'm going to use the thermometer again in the ear to check your temperature. Ear examination, right and left, it's clear. Next we're moving on to temperature. Okay, so you'll hear some gentle clicking sounds, like so. So I'm just going to calibrate the machine. I want to calibrate the machine. Okay. Just look straight ahead. I'm coming around the right side. And checking the temperature. The right side. That looks very good. 37 degrees there. I'm going for the left ear now. Okay, almost there. What's the temperature? What is the temperature? Okay. It looks as though we have a normal temperature on the right and left side. 37 degrees Celsius. 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, temperature. Degrees Celsius. Left. And that was using the ear canal as the source. So far, so good with the tests. What we have next? Yes, so I'm going to give you an injection now, just to make sure you're feeling excellent. So I'm going to withdraw some liquid. A 2 milliliter injection. 2 milliliters. So I could have your right arm, please. Okay. a slight injection in the upper arm. Excellent, thank you. Just going to dab the area here with some cotton wool. And I'll place a little plaster over the cotton wool just to absorb any excess blood. Interestingly, I have found some little snippers in my doctor's bag, and I just want to trim some of the hair, the forehead and the sides, just so I can visualize your scalp a little bit better. So I'll take a few snips here. We just have the final snippers, just for removing a few excess strands. And from the side. Excellent. Draw a diagram of where we removed some of the hair, and the cranium, and the right side, left side. Excellent. So I'm just going to grab my gloves to have a little feel of the scalp area. Have the blue nitrile gloves. The blue nitrile gloves. Okay. Now I just want you to close your eyes, breathe normally, and have a little feel of the scalp and the side of the head. If you feel any tenderness anywhere that I place my fingers onto the temples, just checking for any vessel engorgement. Vessel engorgement, no vessel engorgement, only temple area. Okay, onto the scalp now. A look at the scalp. That's good. Excellent. Focus on the ocular area now. I'm not going to touch the eyes directly. I'm just going to have a little feel of the lids, upper and lower. Just look straight ahead. Just looking for any cysts of the lids. lower lid area. No signs of any blepharitis. Glazians or the alums. Just lack of scales on the lids. Okay, looking up to the ceiling now. Have you ever experienced any dry eyes? Redness, grittiness, soreness, lacrimation before? Okay. Look down. Look to the right hand side and look to the left. Okay. Just going to try a little light in the eyes, checking the pupils. Keep looking straight. Let's just have a look at the conjunctiva in a little bit more detail. Slight hyperemia in the conjunctiva. Possibly grade 1.5. Look at the left conjunctiva. Excellent. Might be about the same, 1.5. Hyperemia. And the tear duct. Tear duct's known as the lower puncta. The lower puncta. We have to refer you for a slit lamp examination though. Yes, I think we'll make a referral to your optometrist. Just have a look for any dry eye. So you will need a slit lamp examination. Probably some dry eye syndrome. Possibly. 1.5 redness grade, but the lower puncta appear open, so the drainage channel is flowing, but possibly you may have some reflex tearing. So I do have some ocular lubricants. These are ocular lubricants which can prescribe for you a temporary relief for the dry eyes. So what I'm going to do is pop a drop in of my test sample. Ocular lubricants that do not sting. In fact, they may feel or provide you with immediate relief of your symptoms. Looking up to the ceiling, place a drop in the right lower part. Just take a blink for me. Good. I will get the lubricant flowing on the ocular surface. Okay, looking down again. There's a drop in the left. Okay, just look up. Close your eyes a second. Close your eyes. Okay, so. So, move on to the ocular artificial tears. I'm going to prescribe some mini single use. Lubricant drops. Probably going to be looking to use these drops 3 times per day. Both eyes. Morning. Early afternoon. And then before bed. so the pharmacist will be able to decipher my handwriting. The pharmacist should have no trouble there. Okay, so I think that concludes all the tests today. I'm sure you'll reach out to us if you have any further problems in the future. Take care of yourself, and bye for now.